In this presentation, we'll talk about the importance of camera and the olden technology used in camera. Camera is a tool to create memories and a vehicle of information that has shaped our world, and it allows us to live a new adventure. If you have been asking yourselves, why is photography and camera so important, this video might help you. Camera is important because it allows people to see world from a different perspective. You don't have to go far to take beautiful photos. You can do it at home, capturing meaningful moments with your family and friends. Different photography styles with the help of camera are taking portraits, landscape, taking quick selfies, etc. The beauty of photography with the help of camera as a hobby is that it makes you document your life. It allows you to tell stories of yourself with your family to remember for long years to come. Photography is crucial in many areas of science, from astrophotography to photos taken through microscopes. Camera is a tool that contributes relevant data to scientists. Have you ever wondered how the first ever camera looked like?
So, how was the first camera working? Let's explore. It was this man, Ibn al-Haytham, who was responsible for the invention of first camera, which was popularly known as camera obscura during his period, and today it is known as pinhole camera. He was an Arab mathematician, astronomer and physicist. He is also regarded as the father of modern optics due to his major contributions in the visual perception. He was also the first ever man to explain that the vision occurs when light reflects from an object and then passes to one's eyes. So it was a blind belief among the masses of his period that we can see objects due to our eyes, not because of the rays which are hitting the object and then entering your eyes. So he removed all these blind beliefs among the masses and make people acquainted with the fact that why they can see. Now let's see what is basically a camera obscura or pinhole camera. So this was basically a dark room with a tiny hole or opening via which an image was generally projected onto a wall opposite to the hole. See, the most important part of its construction was this hole's size. The size of this hole should be at least 1 upon 1000th of the screen distance to ensure that only the rays which are coming from different points of the object, here it is a bulb, should enter this hole and reach the other side of the wall. Since we want this to be happened and not all other rays which are coming from different points of the other objects to enter this hole, we do such a type of arrangement. Now let's see what is the physics behind camera obscura. Light rays always travel in a straight line, there is no doubt about it. In fact, it is a very obvious fact. But it changes directions when it gets reflected or partly absorbed due to the obstacles present in its path. After hitting the object, they retain the information about the object's surface, such as color, brightness and etc. As a result, what happens, whenever this rays coming from different points of the object, which was here in this case bulb, enter the hole to reach the other side of the wall, they form an image. And what type of image they basically form? They basically form an inverted and reversed image. We all know that what is basically a reversed image, it is left to right, and inverted means upside down. See, modern camera obscuras don't use this simply hole. They instead use a convex lens or concave mirror. Why? Due to their converging properties.
Evolution of camera. It all started with camera obscura in the 11th century. The very first true camera was invented in the time 1830s, which was a daguerreotype, which uses a special copper plate to capture the light from the image. It used to take up to 15 minutes of exposure to fully capture the image. So dry plates were born in the time 1850s. This camera used to take 2-3 seconds to exposure. The camera was big. The world needed portable cameras. Then George Eastman created flexible roll films, which made portable cameras possible. Then the 35mm camera came. These cameras use convex lens to take real inverted images. This is because the light rays always travel in the straight line until a light ray hits a medium. The medium in this case is glass. The glass causes the light rays to refract or bend. This causes them to form inverted on the opposite side of the medium. In the time 1991, digital camera were invented, which have greatly changed the way of camera work. In a digital camera, light from the thing you are photographing centers in the camera through a lens. This incoming pictures hits the image sensor chip, which breaks it up to millions of pixels. The sensor measures the color and brightness of each pixel are stored in as a number. Now there's no need of to click a perfect pic. You can easily delete ugly posts and just take another one. Thanks to technology, camera can now be found anywhere. Phones, computers and everywhere.
Let's look at some of the disadvantages and advantages of camera obscura in comparison with the modern day camera. The main disadvantages are: proper exposure requires a trial and error approach. It requires manual control of shutter speed and it is very difficult to control. Poor image quality. It is because of the diffraction effects. Long exposures and it may lead to blurry images if the subject moves. Fixed aperture or f-stop. And the advantages include large depth of field, inexpensive, robust and nearly 100% reliable. If used properly, it can create artistic effects. So, by now, you must have understood the physics and history behind camera obscura. You should also have a much better understanding of how the camera developed over the centuries. The discussion on the image formation and the basic elements of camera obscura and some basic improvements that were added to cameras to make them work better might have improved your knowledge. We hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.